The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language, the precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language, as a meaning-making system, that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the world views of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the world views of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special. The precision of the lines on the map, the consistency with which symbols are used, the grid and/or projection system, the apparent certainty with which place names are written and placed, and the legend and scale information, all give the map an aura of scientific accuracy and objectivity. Although subjective interpretation goes into the construction of these cartographic elements, the finished map appears to express an authoritative truth about the world, separate from any interests and influences. The very trust that this apparent objectivity inspires is what makes maps such powerful carriers of ideology. However unnoticeably, maps do indeed reflect the worldviews of either their makers or, more probably, the supporters of their makers, in addition to the political and social conditions under which they were made. Some of the simple ideological messages that maps can convey include: this land is and has long been ours. Here is the center of the universe. If we do not claim this land, the enemies you most fear will. As a system for transmitting specific factual information without any distortion or ambiguity, the sign system of honeybees would probably win easily over human language every time. However, language offers something more valuable than mere information exchange. Because the meanings of words are not invariable, and because understanding always involves interpretation, the act of communicating is always a joint, creative effort. Words can carry meanings beyond those consciously intended by speakers or writers, because listeners or readers bring their own perspectives to the language they encounter. Ideas expressed imprecisely may be more intellectually stimulating for listeners or readers than simple facts. The fact that language is not always reliable for causing precise meanings to be generated in someone else's mind is a reflection of its powerful strength as a medium for creating new understanding. It is the inherent ambiguity and adaptability of language as a meaning-making system that makes the relationship between language and thinking so special.